Peter Block in Orlando at the AHA annual meeting. Here for On the Scene, and with me is Nihar Desai from Yale. Nihar has been working with the NCDR registry, which has been a big deal as far as the American College of Cardiology is concerned. And Nihar has been working at something that no interventionalist like me likes to hear, and that is, what is or how much inappropriate revascularization are we doing? So let me just ask you at the front end, how'd you do this study? What'd you look at?
Great. Thank you very much for having me. So we looked at about 2.6 million PCIs from July of 2009 to December of 2014, and we found about a 50% reduction in the performance of inappropriate PCIs over that time interval.
So let me understand exactly what you really found. I mean, you started out saying this is the number that you had, and then as you went on, you saw a reduction, or how did you make that final conclusion?
Yep. So in 2009, we applied the AUC criteria and found that about 26.2% of all non-acute or elective PCIs were classified as inappropriate. And by 2014, that proportion was down to 13.3.
Boy, and that's truly inappropriate classification rather than that sort of yellowish, maybe, maybe not kind of stuff?
Yeah, really good point. So I think the AUC have really created three designations. So, of course, there's the appropriate, where the procedure is likely to improve a patient's health status or outcomes. Then you have the inappropriate, where it's unlikely. And then there's the intermediate or uncertain zone. And what we were looking at was the truly inappropriate procedures.
So, you know, I must say, Nihar, that blows me away a little bit that the numbers were that high. Truly, that number of inappropriate seems, I mean, this is fodder for the Office of the Inspector General, is it not?
So, so one of the things is previous studies have shown that about up to 1 in 6 elective PCIs were classified as inappropriate. One of the challenges we faced in our analysis was that it was a 5-year interval, but during that time, the appropriate use criteria were revised. And so we chose to apply the 2012 criteria over the entire study interval, and that did raise the numbers at the early part of the study. But again, it's a 50% reduction. I think it's a really positive finding.
I think that's great, and the NCDR registry probably helped make that happen. Now, let me make a statement that I want to be sure you agree with me on, and that is, even though the AUC criteria say it's inappropriate, inside of those cases, there are many cases that, in fact, are very reasonable to do a PCI on. Would you agree with that?
Absolutely, 100%, and that's a point that we emphasized in the presentation, and it's a point we emphasize in the manuscript, that even though the procedure is classified as inappropriate, there may be very compelling clinical circumstances that would absolutely support that intervention. And rightfully so, the AUC have now replaced the term inappropriate with rarely appropriate to sort of, you know, signify that there may be compelling circumstances that would support that intervention, even though it's classified as inappropriate.
Right. And I was being cute when I said the Office of the Inspector General, would use this, because obviously, number one, they can't. But more importantly, I think it's important to point out that there are a number of these cases where, you know, rarely do they really come out as being inappropriate, and these have to be individually adjudicated and looked at carefully. Nonetheless, and I think this is the point for all the interventional cardiologists out there, nonetheless, the reduction really means that people are starting to think carefully about who they do and who they do not do an intervention on.
Yeah, I think it's a huge success story for cardiology. We faced this issue. We faced some criticism several years ago, and I think the profession has responded and responded vigorously to say we're going to address this, and we're going to work to make sure that procedures are being applied and used in the settings and for the patients who are most likely to benefit. I think it's a tremendous achievement and a sign of our professionalism that over a 5-year time span, we've seen a 50% reduction in inappropriate PCI.
Thank you very much.